Everybody, it's your boy the Slab Train. Welcome back, guys. Midnight Club episode number 5 here on the channel for today. And we went ahead off camera and beat some races. Now, I've already done all the races for the lowriders. We've accomplished some other things as well, too. And we're sitting pretty with $40,000. Now, that next leads into what car should we be driving next. Now, unfortunately, I have not unlocked Group 3 vehicles, and there's not much in Group 2 vehicles that I really do want. Now, I mean, there's a couple of the muscle cars that I would like, but again, we already own a muscle car. I would like to save up the money for a Group 3 spec vehicle. Now, mind you, I mean, the RX-8 would be great. I almost said 7. I caught it, though, man. I caught it. That's just a force habit, you know what I'm saying? I like the RX-7 more than the 8. So the 7 comes before the 8. I mean, that's just my personal preference. Now, I am thinking about also buying the Ducati Monster. But, on the flip side of things, if I wait for Group 3, I'm going to get a badass 2006 Ducati 99R. 9R, sorry. 999R. 9! Alright, but, with that being said though, we're going to back out of the garage. We're going to leave the Riviera in the garage for today. Now, going to the comments from last episode, the Asian Kid, I'm not being any kind of racist or stereotype, I mean, that's just his name right now. The Asian Kid commented, "Hey Slap, didn't you buy a Riviera last Let's Play?" Now, somebody else commented, said, "Yes, he did, even though he said he was going to use other cars." Man, I didn't know this. I did not know that I had the Riviera last time. I actually did not think that I did. I haven't checked it, so if anybody wants to go over there and, you know, confirm that, that'd be great, but I'm pretty sure I haven't got it. I mean, that's just, I'm just thinking right now, man. I mean, smelt a little bit of burning. Oh, why didn't we not have that equipped? That doesn't make any sense. Thankfully, nitrous is already equipped. Okay, we should be good. And you know what? I'm feeling a paint job on this Camaro. I really am. I had a lot of people saying that they just didn't like the door being black. So we're going to go ahead. Oh my God, dude. We need body parts, doors. We need that to be a red. Is that even the right red? It's a different color red. That's it right there, I think. It still doesn't look right, though. Maybe a different color. Oh my God, dude. Maybe that's good. I mean, it still looks different, though. All right, we're going to try this here. Primary. There we go. Yeah, baby. A little bit of a pearlescent two-tone on this Camaro. I like it. I do like it. And for our special ability, and we do have Roar, which is nice, but I'm thinking about using Zone. We haven't used Zone this entire time, so I think that will be cool. We're going to go, let's go front to back on that. That lowering pattern, that's going to be pretty cool. Hydraulics is enabled as well, too. That's good. And maybe vinyl editor. We haven't touched anything to do with vinyl editor, so let's try this out here. Let's see what we got. Now, I mean, obviously, you know, we have a Camaro. I don't know how well these vinyls are going to look. Oh, damn. Okay. Not bad. That actually looks pretty badass. I'm not going to lie to you. Let's see what else we got. DC Sports. You can't go wrong with DC Sports. Number 63? I mean, that looks pretty badass, I'm not gonna lie. They have some solid vinyls on this game. Absolutely solid. We got a dub edition race paint? Okay, what about this dub? What do we got? Ooh, that's crazy right there. Okay. What about HKS? See what we got. Probably nothing too crazy. Oh, damn. That's some old school Need for Speed 2 right there. Oh. You know what? I'm doing it, man. I think I'm going to go with that. Let's see what else we got here first. Just to see. Just to see. See if any of these catch my eye. T-Mobile. Oh, yeah. Let's shove a T-Mobile sticker on the side of my Camaro. That sounds like a great idea. We're going with HKS. Now, the only thing is, is, what is this, package 2? What the hell is this? Yeah. All right, so we have our Camaro ready to go out on the streets of LA. Doc wants to race, so he's cruising around on Century Boulevard in his old school 65 Malibu. We're gonna go find this man, and we're gonna hopefully take his ride. That's the plan, and we gotta turn him in as well, too, up ahead. Thankfully, Doc is actually in range, man. Look how close he is. Oh, Jesus, cops.
Another day in LA.
God damn. Sir, you don't want this. I'm out of here. Maybe we should stop. What do you think? Nah, let's go, man. We're out of here. Oh, jeez. My bad. He lost us, hopefully. We're going too fast for him. We're going to have to make a right, though, because Doc is going to be probably way behind us after this pursuit is said and done. Let's just go ahead and make our way back. You can't see me, sir. Oh, we went the wrong way. Thank you. And we are out of here. Look at this. Cops evaded. Give me that 70 rep. And there's Doc, just as I suspected, back there waiting. Now, today, though, I wanted to touch base on a couple things today, man. Now, we have some big news that have kind of been leaked. You know, I've talked about it a little bit before, but I wanted to really give, you know, my explanation on why it makes me so upset about this happening. Now, in the past Need for Speed games, you know, we have seen the games kind of mixed up with manual transmission and non-manual transmission. Now, I'm gonna be honest. Now, as a racing enthusiast, gamer, you know, car guy, drives a standard transmission car, pretty much like every other car guy would, right? Now, all these games that we have played, you know, Midnight Club offers manual transmission, you know, Need for Speed Underground 2 offered manual transmission. Why am I smoking this wall? Oh my god. Gotta be nice and smooth on the stick. Smooth does it, man. Smooth does it. It's just a one-on-one battle, eh? Okay. So, pretty much, you know, we have grown up driving and playing racing games with manual transmissions. It's just a given thing, you know, when you play a racing game, you're gonna go to the menu and you're gonna say, I wanna use manual transmission. Now, the games that I have let slide in the past because of this would be Grand Theft Auto 5. Now, mind you, I still think that game should have manual transmission. 100%, it should happen. They should find a way to integrate that into the controls. You know, whether they do a button where you have to hold with it, I don't know. But I feel that they should give you the option, at least. You know what I'm saying? They gotta give you that choice. And everybody needs choice in the matter. Now, I've been hearing rumors. Now, I don't think anything's been confirmed or denied about this, but Need for Speed not having manual transmission. You know, people have kind of said the same thing. Apparently, there's been a rumor mill floating around that there is no manual transmission. Now, to me, that's a problem. You know what I'm saying? That's a huge, huge problem in the racing community's world. Because let's be honest, we've been waiting for this game for so long. And I know, we're in slow motion, right? I mean, almost. I started saying that right as we got out of it, and I didn't want to break character. But as I was saying, I mean, we have been, you know, just, man, it's just been tough. It really has been. We have been seeing all these racing games that are coming out. You know, Project Cars was supposed to be huge. That died out so fast because of no cars in there. You know, all the other bugs and fixings in that game. You know, we have Forza 6 coming along. That game has no auction house, no created lobbies, you know, the whole nine. And, you know, it's just all of our big light that we have seen on all these games coming out are slowly just dying. Need for Speed now is one of them. You know what I'm saying? If you're playing a racing game, the key is to engage the consumer that is playing the game, whether it be in a, you know, a dynamic storyline, stuff like that. But you also got to think about gameplay. You know, what kind of gameplay is going to bring the consumer in? Manual transmission. It's like having a Call of Duty game with the ability to aim down the sights. It's in that kind of virtue, at least I feel. You know, I feel like it's a given. Whenever you're about to play a racing game, you turn on that manual transmission and you have the ability to. You know, ever since you know, the dawn of time, we've had that option. And, you know, Need for Speed, as well as Burnout, sometimes Burnout does not offer that. I don't think Burnout has ever offered manual transmission. But, you know, those games can get away with that because they're not, you know, mostly a racing-focused game. They are, you know, a crashing game, stuff like that. But either way, though, it's been slid. You know, people have let it slide because it's Burnout. Need for Speed, on the other hand, I feel must have manual transmission. It must have it to make it a Need for Speed perfect game. Rivals did not have manual transmission. That's a problem. I don't understand how these games are coming out, you know, with no manual transmission. And it really, it frustrates me, man. It frustrates me as a consumer, you know, as an older gamer now as well, too. I mean, maybe they're trying to tailor to the younger crowd again, like they did with Rivals, you know, saying, oh, we have this and that, but there's no manual transmission. What older adult gamer is going to want to play a racing game just steering the car and gas and brake and a handbrake? You know what I'm saying? It may be fun for a little bit, but you're not going to get those avid gamers that are going to keep coming back to the game. You know, they have went ahead and I'm pretty sure they have tuning in the game. They have tuning, but they don't have manual transmission. That's like 1 and 1 equals 3. That doesn't make any sense. And I just shouted out Ray William Johnson. I'm pretty sure that's the name. But all I'm saying, though, is that it's really unacceptable that these games are coming out without manual transmission. I mean, I'm just a consumer. You know, I don't have too much of a say, but, you know, I wish that they would maybe give a statement as to why they are bringing out one of the most highly anticipated games of the year next to Forza 6 with no manual transmission. Absolutely just, it's crazy, man. It's ludicrous is what it is. It really is. And, you know, I hope that, you know, they can work on it and put out something before the release date, but, you know, I feel like I'm at a loss of words, man. I'm frustrated more than anything. I really am, because that game was going to be awesome. It was going to be exciting. Mind you, I'm still playing the game. I'm still going to buy it. But will it be the game that I expected? No, it won't be. And it won't have that feel of, you know, driving your own car, because you're just hitting gas and brake. That's all you're doing. Maybe handbrake. But you don't have the ability to shift gears. You don't have the ability, you know, to bang rev. You know, maybe do some, you know, clutch drop, stuff like that. But in the whole grand scheme of things, I feel it's going to really reduce their sales of the game. Once manual transmission gets out there that it's, you know, it's not in the game, for a lot of the avid fans of Need for Speed, they're going to look at that and think it's just another Rivals. And I don't know if you guys can feel me on that or not, but to me, though, Need for Speed 2015 is an extension of Need for Speed Rivals. Correct me if I'm wrong, ladies and gentlemen. Correct me if I'm wrong. But that's what it feels like. Yes, we have the customization. Yes, we have all this. We have the tuning. Brings us back to the Need for Speed days. You know, the Underground series. We have the dynamic, you know, customization now again. Oh! Holy shit! We got it, we got it, we got it. Almost died, but we got it, though. Oh, no! No! Give it to me! Oh, my God. How far away are we? We're gonna try and maybe, I don't know if this is gonna work or not. I'm gonna try and do this here. Get off my screen, map! Come on! I don't think this is gonna work, ladies and gentlemen. Go, 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 go! Hit the station, give me some spray! We have to haul some ass right now. They are so far ahead. Try and use their zone as well, too. But I mean, like I said, though, it doesn't feel like an Underground game. As much as they want to make it look like Underground 2, the game will never be the same unless we have tuning. And that is, or sorry, not tuning, but manual transmission. To me, it's just another Rivals, man. You guys can let me know in the comment section down below your thoughts about that. But that's how I feel about the game. It's just, it's not the same, man. It's absolutely not the same. I'd love to know everybody's thoughts about that, because, you know, I've been very excited for Need for Speed to come out. You know, they have the whole new customization game. They have all these crazy things getting implemented, but, you know, we're seeing a lack of gameplay to really make us keep on playing. And I feel like that is something that is going to make people keep playing. And did I go the wrong way again? Oh my god, dude. Excuse me. I gotta get through here. Alright, come on, man. We gotta make this. If we can catch up, it's gonna be an epic comeback. Just epic. No! Okay. No, it's fine, man. It's fine. Son of a... He's so gone, man. He is definitely gonna be making this. Be coming in second place for damn sure on that. Oh my god, dude. I mean, technically, we're still on podium. We came in second place. If you ain't first, you're last, though, right? We're gonna have some fries on this one here. I got some nice good old French fries right here. And it's one apiece. Group 2 vehicle performance levels. Hell yeah, baby. Let's go, man. Let me know what you guys are munching on. I just finished a delicious burger before this episode. That's why I got some leftover French fries. Just kind of munching away on them. Here we go, baby. Get those hydros working. Woo! Where is he going, man? Okay. Let's go, Doc. You can come up beside me, sir. Just get him, man. Come on, pit maneuver. Slows us both down. Oh, man. I'm topped out in second gear. I didn't even notice. Come back. Jack. Doc. Come on, man. Now, as well, too, guys, last episode I announced my second channel that I started up. If you guys did not see that, we have about 4 episodes now up on Batman Arkham Knight. Game is insane, man. Absolutely insane. Okay. Game is insane, though. I cannot lie about that. I've been having a blast playing Batman. Just playing some good games again, man. I don't know if you guys have been over there checking it out as well, too. If you have been, show me your support with the hashtag SlapGaming if you're subscribed to that channel, because that has been an absolutely incredible series. Cannot wait for more games to come out. I've been getting a lot of requests. You know, Slap, are you going to be playing Doom? Are you going to be playing, you know, Star Wars, Fallout? We're going to be playing all of those games once they come out. And that channel is going to be strictly mainly for new games that are already out. You know, we're not going to be going back and playing old school games. Get messed up, Doc. Take care, sir. It's my race today. Oh, Jesus. Where are we at? It's not bad. We're going to take a little bit of a U-turn up here and then a straight shot back, and we should have this race won. Well, you're rolling now. Hopefully, anyways. That's the plan. These muscle cars are so hard to turn on these highways. Turning radius is so twitchy, which is so weird, because you'd think that it wouldn't be, but you just can't turn hard. I mean, they turn fast, but not too hard, if that makes any sense. I don't know. I kind of had to think about that one myself. Don't worry about it, man. I'll be all right. I'm going to win this race. I'm going to take my money, take my respect. I'm going to take Doc's car, whether he likes it or not. You see me get out of this car and just hop into his? GTA status? I mean, it's Rockstar Games, right? I mean, we should be able to do it. Here we go. Now, as well, too, guys, make sure you guys come back later on this afternoon. We got some Project Cars gameplay coming up, and we're going to be discussing Project Cars 2 on that video. So make sure you guys do not miss that. Just more garbage that is just happening. It's just been crazy, man. It's been absolutely crazy. And I hope these companies, you know, straighten up, man. I'd love to see these games come out in full form, you know, ready for a full-on racing experience. And you can't have a racing experience on a game with no manual transmission. Oh my god, I'm sorry I keep going back to that. That's the icing on the cake for everything that's been going on. No, you don't. We are gonna straighten out and we're gonna be good. Whew. Thankfully we had that zone, man. That was good. That was good timing. Series 1, baby. Hopefully we get to take his car home. Please tell me I get it. rear bumpers and spoilers. I didn't want that. We didn't even get his car. Okay.
That's what I'm talking about.
And shut up, dog. I wanted that. It's all right, though. So, what is next on here? Hollywood Lookout Delivery and some series races in Century City. Now, let's go some delivery challenges, man. I'm down to run some of those and see what we can do. We also have a time trial up there. Now, what I'm going to do, I'm going to do a little bit of a cheat code. We're going to pretty much fast travel right to the garage. I'm down for that. But it's going to take me to the wrong garage. Oh, my God. Man just pulled a super hot fire on me. Psych! That's the wrong garage. Oh, man. You know what I'm saying? It's like that. But worse, because we can't even do anything over here. Oh, shit. Woo! Let's see if we can get some hops going with this. Alright, we're gonna kill this lady right here. You ready? Oh, she dipped it! She's lucky, man. She's lucky. Alright, what we're gonna do, we have to drive all the way back to the other garage now. Look at this. We're so far. And thanks to the magic of editing, again, we have fast traveled to our garage. Oh my god, police pursuit. Hell no. We're gonna deliver this Charger. Let's do it. That thing looks nasty, though. Delivery in old Hollywood. Alright, looks like a nice old dub edition. Love those rims, though. Again, people are putting keys in those wheel wells. That's a terrible idea. I mean, I'm gonna start looking at wheel wells for keys. Let's bring home this SRT8, baby! It's actually not far at all and not bad of a drive. Here we go. We're burning rubber. Second gear. Excuse me, lady. All right, so looks like we're gonna be taking a left. Let's take a left up here. We're gonna take a right as well down here, and we should be okay. Hopefully, anyways. Maybe we'll just go through this place. I don't know if this is gonna be a bad idea or not. We'll definitely try. We're taking vehicle damage with these damn fences, though. Jeez! Oh my! Restarting that. That's garbage. We're getting this Charger home. All right, here we go. I think I know the way. We're going to take a left. We're just going to go straight down, and that should curl out to our destination. It should, anyways. Let's have a quick look here on the map. All the way down. Yeah, that should be money. Look at that curl. We're going to hit the spray. I wonder if he has zone on this thing. I doubt it. Not happening. Sorry, that's my phone, not your guys. Stop looking. Woo! 30 seconds. Alright, 160 we're hitting. We gotta make a decision. Which road? Right here. Jeez! 17 seconds. Coming up to 10. Oh yeah, we got it. No worries, let's bring it in upside down just to trash it. Delivery successful until he finds out that the thing's flipped. He took our money, $2,700. I might as well do the last one, right? Let's do it, man. Oh, we got the vet. I'm pretty sure that plate just said tail happy. It does. That's badass. Oh my god, that looks way too far. Look at this. Oh my god. I'm looking at the map and driving. I'm gonna go this way. Excuse me, man. Get out the way. Alright. Should be okay. Oh my god, I was looking. Looking at the map again. Already lost half the life on this thing already. We're gonna go through these hills and we should be okay. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys once again for coming around for some more Midnight Club. If you enjoyed it, and if you're still here, don't forget to slap that like button. Show me the support in the comments section down below, ladies and gentlemen. And as always, too, guys, you can follow me on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. And if you guys have not already, you can go and subscribe to my second channel. As I said, we're doing our Batman Arkham Knight Let's Play. We're about 5 episodes in. So I hope you guys are enjoying that as well, too. I'm gonna take a left up here. Hopefully, we can bring this baby home. She hasn't been too tail happy though, thankfully. Should be just a straight shot. 20 seconds on the clock. Come on, man. 13, 12. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you guys very much for watching today. Jump on the slab train. I'm out. Peace. Everybody, it's your boy, the Slab Train, and welcome back, guys.